Gulf Roku. This is my father, his name is Mr. Momoi Tria Matthias. In Africa, the name goes last name and then middle name and then first name, it's backwards. So that's just a picture of him real quick so I can show you what he looks like. And the eulogy I did for him was pretty short and sweet, but I'm going to be talking for you because it's a long, long eulogy. Gandhi once said, whatever you do in life may be insignificant, but it's very important that you do it, because if you don't do it, no one will. This explains my father's life very well. A lot of people have fathers, I imagine you kind of need one to be alive. A lot of people don't have fathers in their lives, that's common. And most commonly, when your father's in your life, it doesn't influence you as much as other people would influence you. My father wasn't in my life that much, as I moved to America, but he influenced me more than anyone else in my life, aside from my mother, of course. My father was a very, very caring person. He did things that most men would not do. He was born a poor man. His first pair of shoes he got when he was 16 years old. His first pair of shoes, and he was so excited. He looked at all his friends in the eyes, and looked at his shoes, and looked at the eyes again, so like to see his new shoes. He got shoes at first time in his life. He was a self-made man. He grew up very, very poor, like I said, and he worked all his life to get money, and finally had no money to take care of himself and his family. He went to school in London for a marketing degree, which is interesting because I'm doing marketing as well, so I kind of have a bond on that. He was a teacher at a university and a high school in my country, so he kind of loved education, loved helping people learn and improve themselves. He was also a mayor in my town, so anyway, before I was born, he was a mayor, and he had some power and felt really good about himself, and I was very respected in my city. So in my town, everyone knew who I was when I was born. We were the Moines family, everyone knew I was better street name after ourselves and everything else. It's kind of cool. And lastly, he allowed us to come to America. My sister told me when I called her and talked about my dad to her, she said, your father didn't want you guys to come here. He didn't want us to come here. He thought that, leaving your kids to come to America and not knowing that you ever see them again is a scary thing because it's your children. That's all he had, it was his kids. And letting us come to America, he would have done a lot. He would not know to see us again. So he was kind of nervous about that. But he did because he knew that we didn't have a future in Cameroon. So he thought that coming to America, we would have a future. So he let us come to America. Myself and my dad shared beds until I was 9 years old. So we slept in the same bed because there was like very few beds in my house. And we had to somehow get me a place to sleep. So I slept in the same bed with him. And my mom told me when I called her that whenever I was coming to America, he started crying because I was the youngest person that youngest of his kids. And he didn't know if he ever was going to see me again, so he started crying at the airport. I don't remember this because I was so amazed by airplanes that I wasn't paying attention to what was going on. But when I heard about that, it made me sad because I thought he didn't like me, but apparently he cared more about me than anyone else, and he wanted me to stay there more than anyone else. My dad made a big impact in my life. He showed me how to care about people, how to take care of people without putting yourself second, and knowing that your compassion can be very important and your love is what everyone needs love, that's all we need, and he showed me that. He helped me set my life goals. The reason why I want to build hospitals in Africa is because my dad passed away because of maltreatment. He was in the hospital and he had diabetes. And he was given insulin, which is sugar. A poor diabetic cannot handle sugar. He gave me insulin. He died because of that. That killed him. He always put his pride aside for helping out people. Culturally, women are not allowed to leave my country without the husband's approval because women have my country have no rights almost. And my dad let my mom go because he knew that we would have a better future here, and so he let her go, even though his friends made fun of him for that. He taught me what faith was like. He taught me like faith is very important and that it's always important to be a religion first and care about your neighbor more you care about yourself. And when I got to his funeral in Cameroon, I saw how much they needed help. My country has not changed in the last 10 years of me being gone. It's the same country that I left, and it's not going to change because no one's there to care and love them like they need. So when I went home and saw that, I figured that if I can be in America, enjoy life, and forget them, that's wrong with me. How can I do that when my dad gave me a chance to improve myself? Why can I not go back and improve my country? And my dad worked so hard to improve, but he couldn't because he died. So above all, my father taught me so much without actually being there. He taught me how to live my life, how to care, how to love, and how to be and make an impact on other people's lives. The quote when I started to say was whatever you do in life is insignificant, but it's very important that you do it. Whatever he did in life was insignificant to most people around him, but it was very important he did it, because by him doing that, I might go home now and build a hospital. I might do things that I would have not done if he didn't do what he did. So that was my father, Mr. Mohamed Tria Matthias.